I'm very glad to introduce you the two projects that go under the name of DeCoSe, which means designing collaborative services for the smart cities. Our challenge was therefore to build a collaborative service which was based on web technologies as well as on an approach which is called Living Lab. Here you can see two frameworks in which our project were working. On one hand, we had Peripheria, which is a European Commission pilot B action, which is meant to build services that are based on future internet technologies, as well as on the Living Lab approach. As you can see, Peripheria has six arenas in Europe, and we decided to work on Milan because it was the easiest choice, and in a way it was the easiest place to work on. During the project, anyway, we had the chance to see other two arenas, one in Genoa and one in Malmo, Sweden. The other framework was the one of Campus Sostenibile, which you all know is a project now undergoing here in this area to transform this district into a specimen sustainable district for 2015 exhibition in Milan. The Campus Sostenibile is organized by four discussion tables, and since our first research was focused on people, on users, on citizens in the campus, we were drawn to the people table, which was the table that was discussing issues concerning people. And from the people table, that's the moment in which our teams divided, and Team A chose to follow the urban challenge, therefore focusing on the urban, the community aspect of the project, while the MCO project, the Team B, decided to focus on the behaviors challenge of the people table. And now I give the word to the Team A to explain the project.
Hello. So this is Team A, and it's called, the project and the service is called Talk Talk. Someone has what you need. So I'm going to introduce to you how did we develop the system of the Living Lab approach into a social innovation boost. So here we have the whole trip from the challenges to the idea, the experiments, the development, and the actual implementation. First of all, as Andrea discussed before, we have two different backgrounds and two different goals. The first ones came from the people table that basically are the involved and the engagement of the community. And then from the field analysis that we've done in common with Group B, we have, of course, the goals to create a useful service to close the cycles of the city, which means to reincorporate resources into the city, and, of course, to share the knowledge between the two types of stakeholders that we have here, which are students, and then, of course, living the residence community. Okay, why did we use the Living Lab approach? Of course, this is a very rich approach that engages the concept that users have an intelligence to give, and the local community have a lot to offer. So we base on this knowledge in order to take it to a co-design process to have new perspectives and a really well-based service. What is TalkTalk? What does it do? So basically, we're a collaborative service that supports the creation of a living community, and it's a multi-platform that allows the exchange of material and immaterial things. Why is it called Talk Talk? Well, actually, we go from the name Knock Knock, which calls for asking and going to your neighbor's house and asking for anything in return. So this collaborative community starts from there. We have two basic missions. The first one is, of course, to foster sociability through a web-based living community. And second of all, to reduce consumption. And we do this through fostering exchange and reuse. Okay, we basically base our system in four different features. The first of all is the synchronous barter. The second of all is a hybrid user experience. And what we mean by this is that we're both talking about a service that works in real, physical life, and of course, in the digital world. Then, of course, we always base our things in ethics for sustainability. And then last but not least, ensuring that the user has this confidence to use the service, and of course we want to make it safe for them to use. So rating confidence system. this is the process from research through the future's perspective. So, of course, research has been a very constant thing throughout the project because we're based on a living lab approach. But let's say that the first basic research took place from September all the way to February. Then we started to work on the service proposal. Then we went to the experimental phase. Then application and development that run, let's say, at the same level with the business model. And then finally, we're going to present the future perspectives that we have ahead. So the first thing we did was create a viral strategy to get to know the project. So we developed both on two levels. The physical one, which was a guerrilla strategy throughout the campus to inform people. And then on the second one, we have this...
The mouse.
We have the second one that went on digitally. This video took you to the social media places. After this, we realized on all this viral strategy, we had the first experiment, Living Lab experiment, which was called Happy Book Hour. What we asked for people here was to bring just a single object, a common object, which was a book, and we went and put them all together to do the actual exchange. So we found out that people started to work and collaborate and discuss about it while they were in the party. And then afterwards, we asked them to understand, to say what they were willing to offer as a skill, because we were part of the investigation wants to understand if people is willing or not to also share their skills. Okay, so we had really good results. We managed to exchange nearly 30 books. We got to through Facebook to 5,000. So the experiment went on, and we got 75 new users on Facebook, but most importantly, we also worked with 50 new people that wanted to keep working on us and ask for new events. The second experiment was called Vesti Amici, and here we stepped to the next level, trying to involve the people from the community. So we went directly to mothers and children, and the two major schools here in the zone, and then we tried to exchange basically their objects of everyday use, that would be clothing, accessories, and toys. Here we tried to manage to make awareness about how people can do this exchange and how much they were interested on it. So we got a really good response, because even if we didn't get directly to schools, mothers were really interested in what we were doing, because for them it's a basic need. And last but not least, we kept, throughout this process, of course, a set of interviews in which we gather constant feedback from what they think and what they could do for the community. And I'm going to give the word to Lucia about the development.
Okay. Right after the experiment, we decided to go deep in the definition of the service, and we started to focus on the features. First feature was the fact that we don't want to exchange not only objects but also material competencies. Then we want to increase the user awareness towards their use. And finally, the geotag offers, because the fact that the people can geotag the things inside the local dimension, it's something that can enrich the project. Using a Living Lab approach, for us, it was necessary to have a feedback from experts. So we decided to go to Media Lab, that is a research laboratory in Malmo, at the University of Malmo. And we have the occasion to present our project to the professor Berlinde, And in that 2 days of workshop, we developed a prototype of the service. In this way, we went deep in the project and we understand better how it works. I want to add also that Malmo is one of the arena of peripheral project, and it is the cutting edge arena in Europe. Here we are at the real practical phase. After our trip, our visit in Malmo, we discovered that we were the winners of the Social Innovation Camp. That is a prize held each year in Europe, in different countries. And this year it was held in Italy, at the hub di Milano. And through the Social Innovation Camp, we have the occasion to focus on new features and to make easier the discussion with experts and mentors. We decided to focus our attention on the exchange of objects and not competencies. In this way, we can give more attention to the business plan, and we started thinking to create a startup from this event. Here we are at the Hub Milano working on the project, and this is the mockups that we produced in that days. We can see first the page of login and the possibility to login also with the social network like Facebook and Twitter. Then the profile page in which we ask the user to describe why they want to be part of TokTok and in what sense they are sustainable. And the three factor for the reliability, the exchanges, how many exchanges in the community I do, and the badge, and finally the media of exchange. Then we have the page of the offer page, in this case a book. And finally, as we said, the possibility to tag the offer inside the quarter. During the C-Camp, we focus also on the state of the art of our competitors, and we cluster them in three parts: the exchange and reuse, the borrow and the share, and the knowledge and time. TokTok wants to be in the center, want to merge all these three factors in order to be something that can serve all these three main aspects. And we can see that the local community awareness is very important for TokTok. I just want to underline the X-Tribe competitor because it can be a possible case of plagiarism that we will show you later. Thanks to the C-Camp, we were interviewed by Milano Finanza, and our interview was broadcasted on the CNBC channel. Then another interview was published on the Idee Green, a site on sustainable ID. And then we participated at the Tavoli Thematici for Expo 2015, in which we present our idea and we receive some interesting feedbacks. Here we are at the Periferia conference on the arena of Milano. And finally, we are in the Smart City exhibition in Bologna, where maybe we can say that two guys has plagiarized our idea, because at the end of the day, they open up the web page of the application, X-Tribe. And this was the last occasion in Genoa. We presented our idea and we compare our way to work with the call of ideas in Genoa at that bar camp. From service to startup. After the C-Camp, Avanzi, which is a consulence company, and MakerCube, a spin-off of Avanzi, asked us to collaborate. And then what happens? We participate at another social innovation camp, crowdsourcing social innovation camp, in which we developed three features: freemium model, TokTok corners, and credit system. Thanks to the collaboration with the C-Camp, we participate at the MUR, Smart City and Social Innovation. This is a picture. And next step, we want to form a company, follow acceleration programs, tend to make a cube, and maybe a partner with Politecnico for internship, and a designed application that my colleague will show you hereafter.
Thank you. The mockups realized has been concretized with a beta version of our service. A beta is an incomplete product to test the user's reaction and to give us feedback. Our service has been realized with a mobile web application that is similar to popular web application like Facebook Mobile or Gmail Mobile. And this kind of application are application run inside a mobile web browser like Safari Mobile or Chrome Mobile. At the end, this kind of application can be also encapsulated in a container to become a real native app. Our app has been developed thanks to open technologies like HTML5, CSS3, and we used also an framework for the front-end, jQuery Mobile. While in the back-end, we used Java technologies like Java Enterprise Edition. I will leave the details of the development for the final questions. So, the screenshot. We can see that the mobile web application can be also look like as a normal application. We have the login screen right after the landing page, and we have also the profile of the user, where there are shown his details and his engagement in our platform. Then we can see right there the details of our platform, so a user can search for offer inside our application according to categories or also according to keywords. Then he can insert new offers and write also the story of the object that he is inserting in our platform. Then at the end, we allow also our user to explore their cities and their neighborhood thanks to geolocation. But the development of an application has not been enough for us because we wanted to demonstrate the self-sustainability of our application. So we built a business model based on four main points. Talk credits. A credit system based on the exchange. So users are rewarded for each exchanges. So the more you exchange, the more you gain credits. These credits can be used inside the platform and also in businesses near our philosophy, namely TokTok Corners, which are businesses that provide us a corner to make this exchange in the physical world. Then we have a mixed subscription model that provides free users and premium users. The difference lies that the premium users are allowed to buy credits and to accomplish the exchanges with these paid credits. At the end, we have also TokTok Cafe, which are our flag houses of reuse, let's say. And these spaces are abandoned building in the city that which are converted by us to this scope. The business model has been concretized in a business plan. These trends are our base, and as we can see, these tendencies are drawn by popular web services like Dropbox or Gmail Mobile. We based our revenue stream on these tendencies, and we can see that at the beginning of our venture, the main income are TokTok Corners, so the fee paid by these businesses. But at the end, the main income will be represented on the variable factors like credits and premium users. At the end, we can conclude that our venture will be profitable because we can see that the first year will be experimentation to develop our beta and to get a very wide user base. Then, second year, start the commercial activities. We will be in loss, but right after, in the third year, we will be business profitable. So, if you have money to invest on us, please tell. So, thank you for this opportunity and thank you for the attention.
Good evening, everybody. We are the Anchor team, as I say, the team B of the DeCoSe project. I'd like to present. We'd like to present the project that has its name in ANCO, where CO stands for community, collaboration, and co-design. let's say the project aims to be a collaborative service with the aims of strongly reducing the amount of waste that every day are produced in each specific urban area. In particular, the project is doing that by networking the ones that are willing to get rid of specific materials that they do consider wastes, and with the ones that are willing to use raw materials that are not achievable in that moment. So in this moment, the network doesn't exist, but the project is actually willing to create it. As I was saying, the project aims of being a collaborative service, as the DeCoSe acronym stands for. Let's say that we have started by focusing on the framework of the university campus, in particular the one of Politecnico of Milano, that has been our arena of focus, as it was presented before. And it has had, at its initial point, a framework that was mainly made by the Peripheria context, which is this urban project that we are referring to, and that that is related to certain practices of living lab around Europe. And on the other side, to the Città Studi Campus Sostenibile Network, that is at the moment really present and really ongoing on the field of Politecnico Milano. In this sense, we have needed, as it was said before, to create a background knowledge, mainly on the present experiences of living labs, of smart campuses, and on the tools of design that we were going to use, in particular co-creation, the ones of co-creation, co-design, and collaborative services. Thanks to that, we have had the possibility of joining Tavolo People in the framework of Città Studi Campus Sostenibile, and in this sense we have chosen to respond to the behavior challenge that the table was proposing to us, in particular trying to understand what were the unsustainable behaviors around the campus and in this sense how it was possible to change them, in particular through our co-design process, as to say, through a process that was letting us making people aware and involved and being the primary actors of the change. We've needed, therefore, to analyze the context and to analyze the field, in particular to analyze the unsustainable behaviors in an indoor and outdoor situation. The indoor outcomes have been mainly the ones of a total lack of a total presence of material waste and therefore of waste of paper, plastic, and so on, a waste of energy, a waste of moreover electric energy. For what is related to outdoor situation, the main situation was related to the lack of commitment present in people, and from this moment on, our project has been related to how to push and boost it.
Decided some specific unsustainable behavior, we went on, and started a really active engagement strategy. This engagement strategy took place inside the university campus in the beginning. Actually, we organized three different experiments, micro experiments inside the university, that had the aim to build an interactive community on which to base the service. The first experiment was called the Please Turn Over, and faces directly the unsustainable behavior of waste of materials. And as you can see, it looked like a reuse workshop. It took place inside the Polyprint, which is the copy center of Polini, inside Campus Leonardo. And may I show you? I can show you a video. A lot of people was involved inside this kind of experiment, and here are some numbers. We, in 2 days, students had been able to produce about 100 of block notes made of reused paper. All this paper was collected in 7 days and was actually given for free by 5 copy centers around here in Campus Leonardo. And yes, it was great because we could test a sort of exchange among a demand and a request of materials. The second experiment was called Post-it, and faced the unsustainable behavior of the lack of social cohesion and the detachment of people inside the campus about the issue of sustainability. It consisted in a physical installation inside the patio area in the campus, and where people were asked to leave comments and new ideas for a better campus. And okay, here some numbers again. And well, this is the Encooperativo. It's an event we organized in order to enhance the gathering of these comments about the campus. And it was a great success again, because it was for the first time inside this community we had the aim to build, we had been able to introduce also people that were not of the academic population, such as citizens, musicians, and friends of the musician, and so on. And so it was. And this is the first and final experiment we had. This is Shut It Down. And it had been a sort of university guerrilla we did inside the university in order to focus people on the issue of energy consumption inside university. And the yellow postcard you can see actually had been angled around the campus, just near to the switches and to the electrical plugins. On one side you can see there are some funny sentences such as keep calm and shut it down and so on, while on the other face of the postcard you can see some very important information that people that was given to people in order to make show him how easy it is to reduce energy consumption in the daily life. And this guerrilla that was physical inside the university had been such a great success that we get as an answer a sort of online guerrilla also on our Facebook page and on our platforms. And about this experiment, also an article was written just to show how big and how impressive was the idea. I'm not going to show you because I think I'm going to lose too much time.
So after this phase of experiments, we started our co-design strategy, and from this moment on, our community was not just done by a university community, but it was enlarged to the neighborhood. So from this time on, also citizens were started to be involved in the project. Obviously, we did all the experiments that Federica has already explained to you to have some results. And so we analyzed the results of the experiments, and we understood that the most interesting idea and probably also the strongest proposal that we did was the idea related to the police turnover experiment. So the idea to get to give for free to people materials that would have been thrown away. So we decided to go on with this idea to reuse waste materials. And obviously our project is about a collaborative service that also tries to solve some burning issue of our society, such for example, the environmental crisis and the daily huge amount of wastes. And Obviously, in order to analyze our idea and to be sure that it would have been a winning idea, we also studied the state of art of the market, in particular two projects, the Remida project in that we also visited in Bologna, that is a sort of emporio where all the waste materials are collected and then give for free to users that are willing to reuse them. And another project that is developed by University of Bologna, Last Minute Market, that works in the alimentary field, and they collect alimentary goods that are not sold by large retailers, thus cutting down a lot where daily waste is. In this phase of study, we also test the feasibility of the service, and in particular we analyze we develop a sort of market analysis, and we test the material supply. And so we did a lot of interviews with some commercial activities in order to be sure that they will be willing to give materials for free, and the feedback was totally positive because everyone was really happy to get rid of waste materials. And in order to have a sort of catalog of waste materials, we also designed this card to fill in according to the features of the material, like, for example, dimension, color. In this way, user can be aware of the materials that they are going to get. And we also analyze materials demand, and in particular, we launched a Survey Monkey among students' community, and in order to understand if they would have been willing to reuse waste materials, for example, in the faculty of architecture to build their models, or in the department to write down on reuse paper. And also in this case, the feedback was really positive. And so after this testing phase of the feasibility of the service, we understood that materials demand and materials supply exist, and so we decided to go on with the idea of the service.
After this feasibility research, we started in ideation the service. The core concept is the idea that what has no more value for a user could have it for someone else. We want to eliminate the concept of material waste, extending the life cycle and the use phases of the materials, reintroducing these materials inside the use and the production cycles, creating a sustainable network between the demand and the supply of materials. The service is based on different flows. In the first flow, ENCO is going to be the first means between this transition of materials, as for example, between an industry and a citizen. In second flow, ENCO just provides the platform through which this exchange could be possible, for example, between two citizens. And the service is based both on a digital platform and a physical platform. For the physical platform, we are developing an ENCO store. Thanks to this store, it is possible to collect all the materials that we take, and it is possible to access the store thanks to a membership system. It is also the base for creative workshops and sensitization activities, and also for consulting and design services for industries in the field of corporate social responsibility. For the digital platform, we are proposing an ENCO app, an application. After the creation of a user profile, it is possible to assess the supply or the demand materials map in order to look for a specific materials, thanks to a geotagging system, or otherwise to upload a material that I want to dismiss and make free for use to someone else. For the incomes, as you can see, the biggest one came from the access to the store and is balanced with the maintenance of the store. even if at the moment we are looking for a free space where to create the anchor store. But we have a lot of other activities that generate an income for us, as for example the supply of specific materials, the consulting and the design service, workshop, and so on. If you remember the first network, here you can see the spreading of the service. We still have the institution and the project we are related with, but also the social actors that are involved in the service. This is a very dynamic network and is created from people at first. Having a little look into the ENCO experience, we created this video, this interactive video, to show and let the service be tested during the Smart City exhibition in Bologna. Let's take as an example the industry case. An industry have to handle the dismissal of waste materials and they want to give them a new life.
Yeah!
We now have two possibilities: recycle the materials. And in this case, we have a lot of advantages, but we also have an economic and environmental high cost to recycle those materials. Otherwise, using the ENCO service, we still have all the advantages, plus the creation of a new network, sustainable network, around the industry, extending the life cycle of those materials. Testing the service. In this case, it is possible to register in the ENCO database, allowing these materials to be used for someone else. In the case of the social, the cultural association, they need to find low-cost materials to produce something. In this case, fabric. They need fabric.
Yeah!
It is possible to buy materials. And of course, you can choose the materials that you want in terms of dimension and colors. But you have to handle the distance and difficulty to find materials and the high cost. Using the ENCO service, we can create a network and a collaboration inside the city, finding materials in a very easy way. It's very economic, of course, in terms of money and environmental, extending the life cycle of materials. In this case, they just search for the material through the ENCO app and find the materials in the ENCO store, and they have a zero cost 10 kilometer material. Then we work in spreading the service. That was a big issue for us, from the neighborhood scale to the city scale. We did so with different workshops and events. The first one was the workshop in Malmo at Medea Malmo University, and then a workshop with the European project Periferia in Milan. Then we participate to the Giornata della Sostenibilità event, sponsored by Campus Sostenibile Project, with two different activities: the installation, This Is Not a Box, and a stand inside the campus spaces. We also participate to the Smart City exhibition in Bologna, and to Recycle Sustainable exhibition here in Milan. And finally, the European Waste for a Week for Waste Reduction. For the fundraising, we participate to a startup competition by Working Capital Accelerator and a crowdsourcing workshop with Make a Cube. Of course, we are making ENCO real, not just an idea. So for the next steps, we are collaborating with NABA. They proposed us to create, to be the first sponsor of a course in the reuse of materials. And they also allow us to use a free space inside the academy where to create the ENCO store. And we have been contacted by Tempi di Carta, a new brand from Studio Mamo Design. They produce products from starting from waste materials, and they want us to be the first supplier of these materials. They also give us a free space where to create the ENCO store. And finally, we are planning to participate to Changemakers Call in the field of sustainability, of course. Be eco. Thanks.